Here in the Western Australian town of Kalgoorlie-Boulder, visitors from outlying communities can sometimes end up staying in third world conditions. But now a new shelter has been built to ease this lack of accommodation. Letitia Griffin finds out more.
Kalgoorlie, the gold capital of Australia. A mining town which attracts tourists and workers from around the country. But just on the outskirts is Boulder Camp, a place made up of transient visitors from the outlying communities which surround Kalgoorlie. Today it's cold and windy, and most of the people here have gathered around the fire to keep warm. But for Tyson, the weather is simply unbearable.
It's really hard. We've got a shower block here, but toilet is funny one. We've got hot water. People, we are struggling really hard.
Bigagan Baringu health workers visit the camp each day. They offer regular medical checkups and provide food.
Feel no good, but I suppose it's like a way of life as well here in Kalgoorlie, you know. To them it's like, you know what I mean? It's their way of life, you know, and it's not, I think for myself, it, I don't know. The best we can do is just help them. Like, we try and get them the firewood and, you know, we have blanket donations and things like that to try and help them through winter and that. Because most of them just pass through, transient, you know, come from, that's it, come into town for a couple of days and then go back home.
With only small shelters to live in, with no electricity and no furniture, these conditions seem almost third world. A predicament that, over the last 2 years, has led to 5 reported deaths. A place of despair in need of some hope.
Well, update it more, better housing than what's out there now, but that's all right. Yeah, better housing out there and electricity, where they could have heaters and stuff going, but because now at the moment, sometimes they got no firewood unless we get it for them, or the Shire will dump a load off, like that load that was there this morning. But if that's not there, they've got nothing. It's just the houses that's there.
But just down the road, a new short stay facility has been built, especially for these transient visitors. Small cabin-type dwellings that are all furnished offer a welcome respite.
That is going to give a secure, safe environment for these people who come in from the lands where there is no alcohol and no drugs, and managed, full-time managed, and they can live out in Wiltshires if they so wish, or they can live in other accommodation while they're in town getting services.
Kalgoorlie-Boulder Mayor Ron Yurovich believes this is the start of a better future for the community. But he feels the journey ahead won't be easy.
That is a big step forward, I think. We have, some of those facilities here, but unfortunately, because of one group don't associate with another group, we believe we've filled that slot now, or we will fill that slot. So that's got to be a better outcome. The biggest problem is that those that are alcoholic, and that goes for the whole population, unless they want to help themselves, unless they have incentives to get out of the rut, nothing will change.
Kalgoorlie-Boulder is home to around 30,000 people. As a gold mining town with the biggest hospital in the region, people from outside communities are forced to travel here for medical assistance and employment. But some of the visiting groups find it uncomfortable mixing with each other. As a result, suitable accommodation can be hard to find. Western Australian Housing Minister Terry Redman hopes the new short stay facility will change this.
We now have a dedicated facility. It has their support. I'm confident they're going to use it, and I'm confident it's going to get the outcomes that it's been designed for.
The new centre will accommodate around 51 people and is designed based on other facilities that work well. For Tyson and those here at Boulder Camp, things are looking up from here.